What's going on, YouTube? You're back with Shades, and we're continuing your Let's Play of Katawa Shoujo. And Jesus Christ, I have to look at the camera when I say that? God. Also, I want to say right now, I don't have any more time today to record more parts, and I did not finish the fifth, the Friday's part for Persona 4. So, this should be released on a Wednesday, I believe. Or Thursday, I don't know which. Probably Thursday, but tomorrow's part should... We'll be back to my old audio for Persona 4. I'm sorry about that, but this mic isn't mine, so... Anyway, despite making a good pace, it's already nightfall by the time I reach the large iron gates in front of the school. Okay, there's a tickle in my throat. I need to get rid of that. Oh, God. While it's nice to have plenty of time to wander around by virtue of living right next to the school, I can't help but get the feeling that very few students actually take the opportunity. Probably not, because I know I don't take the opportunity to leave school, my school, very often. I mean, you kind of need a car to get to places, but there's like a park nearby, there's a reservation nearby where it's just going for a hike, and I don't go there very often, but I'd love to. I've been there once before with friends, and it was a killer workout. Killer meaning, by the time we got to the top, I was almost dead. Oh, God. Sorry about the gagging noise, but... Because my nose gets runny, I tend to gag more. Like, it's always, like, whenever I gag, it's something to do with my nose. I hate it. And, like, my nose always feels congested. Oh, God. Anyway, perhaps I need decongestions. Excuse me, dear God. I'm sorry. Compared to the number of students I see milling around on campus during free time, It's startlingly rare to see anyone around town. Given the large number of accommodations and facilities that the school offers, many of them might simply not see any point in venturing outside, let alone people such as Hanako and Kenji. It makes me wonder if students like Shizune, Misha, and Lily are the exception for the school, rather than the norm. As I wander back to my dorm room, I continue to compare my old school with Yamaku. As I do so, I begin to be surprised that I managed to get even used to this everything that's happened to me. What happened to Lily? Did you walk her home? I hope you walked her home, because you're a douchebag if you didn't. Oh. Wow, I could have thrown this in the last part too. Jesus Christ. Whatever. Keeping it. The next day, I wake up feeling a little lightheaded. It's almost noon already. Sleeping late is fine, since it's a Sunday and there are no classes. Not just a Sunday, though, but the festival as well. From my window, I can already see some people at the soba booth slinging noodles onto plates for people with a craving for low-quality food. I throw back a handful of my morning meds and ponder how to spend the day. There will be a few exams in the coming week, but I don't consider those as ominous as others, so I'm not as worried about them as I probably should be. With no urgent obligations regarding education, I should be free to spend the day at the festival as I like. Finishing my morning routine, I exit into the hallway, intending to go out and find something to eat. Passing by his door, I decide to see what Kenji's up to today out of impulse. Oh no, why do we have to talk to Kenji so goddamn much? I don't like Kenji. I'm curious if he has any plans since everyone's doing something. Then again, I can picture him having built a soundproof shelter in his room. Or possibly something like a fort, complete with no girls allowed sign. And with the girls crossed out and bodies crudely scrawled underneath it. Knocking on his door, which is luckily devoid of any kind of sign, I hear again the unsettling clicking of at least 10 locks being pulled back. The door opens up a crack. Who is it? You're supposed to ask that before you open the door? Oh, it's you. Damn, it's early. It's not really that early. What is it, man? Nothing, was just gonna ask what you're gonna do today. Half the school is out there already. Out where? Why? What? What? Is today special? Why are they there? Who are? I can hear them. It's loud. Don't tell me. Has the invasion begun? He suddenly looks more alarmed. What day is it, man? Yeah, I guess you can't see the big wooden booths outside and people selling stuff. What the hell are you talking about? I have my curtains closed at all times to thwart the snipers. It's the festival. You know that, right? Oh shit, that's today? Damn it! I can't believe I forgot. I don't have my fort finished yet. This is bad. This is going to be a very bad day. It's good you told me this, man. This is going to be a bad day.
Why?
Oh man, they're going to be everywhere. The people. Outside my window. Socializing! I'm going to make this guy as goofy as possible. I don't give a damn. I hate him, so I'm going to make him fun. Kenji rubs his temples nervously, suddenly looking very ill. It's going to be loud as hell. Damn, and I was going to go out today. But now it's ruined. Everything is ruined! This is awful. This sucks. This sucks. What the hell? This really sucks. I can't go anywhere now. There's nowhere to run. Kenji seems nervous. You could say that he's majorly freaking out. This sounds like someone like someone who's very classy, speaking in layman's terms. Like, Kenji seems nervous. You could even say he's majorly freaking out. And then the quotes are there. I can't believe this. So that's what today was. Damn, and I couldn't even prepare for it. I couldn't even brace myself, and now it's here, and I can't do anything. You should have told me this earlier, dude. I mean, at least I know, but I could have known earlier. Imagine what I could have accomplished.
Sorry, I thought you knew.
So I guess you're not going to do anything today?
The weather's even good. Yesterday was really windy, so I thought today would be cold. It's not, though, so there's no reason to stay inside. Yeah, you should check the festival out.
Kenji groans and covers his face with his hands.
No, I can't do it. They'll eat me alive out there, I know it.
That has to be a joke, but he said it with such a straight face, relatively straight.
What are you going to do? We should hang out in here. You can help me build my fort. We might still make it if we work together.
I don't know. I'm pretty hungry, so I thought I'd get some food first and then check out the attractions. Your class project seemed pretty cool, and I gave a hand with it, so I want to see at least that one and chat with Lily, I guess. Speaking of that, don't you have any obligations for the project?
Are you out of your mind? That blind broad is up to no good. I can feel it in my spleen, man. Her presence is like a dark shadow that's in the way of my great vision.
You have awful vision, first off. As expected of blind people.
What?
Besides, I thought that you were also...
He holds up his hand to interrupt me.
Only legally. Metaphorically, I can see farther than any man before me has seen.
Kenji looks stoically into the metaphorical distance to emphasize his statement, thrusting his chin forward to look manlier. Actually, it looks like the corridor wall 2 meters away, but it's all the same.
I can see the future of mankind, and it's a dark one unless the threat of women is stifled.
You realize women are not a threat to mankind? It's men who are a threat to mankind, because men are stupid. Like, women can be stupid too, but, like, less so. In my opinion. Because there are men like you that exist, Kenji. And, like, despite you being a fictional character, I would not doubt that people like you exist. Like, there are, like, 7 billion people in this world. I would not doubt that someone like you exists.
They're everywhere.
He fingers his scarf nervously, faster and faster, like he's trying to start a fire, then slowly begins to calm down once the panic attack finishes running its course.
I'm going to have to find some place to hide in, a safe haven, and then knock the lights out myself so I don't have to experience this horrible day. I have the perfect thing for that. I must prepare now. Don't go to the festival.
Okay.
Later, dude.
The door slowly closes with a low creak, and I don't know how to feel about what Kenji just said.
I don't care! I want him to die! I mean, that's a cruel thing to say, especially in a game like this where everyone has a disability, but Jesus Christ, I don't like his character. Why does he exist? But apparently his ending is a bad ending, so I guess it makes sense.
After buying a plastic plate of takoyaki from a stall belonging to the class next to ours, I take a seat in the school gardens and watch people pass as I attentively nibble away at the rather bland-tasting item.
Aww. I remember when Emmy stopped me from eating fried food.
Bitch.
I wanted to eat fried food, dammit.
I guess I shouldn't complain. It's better than nothing and didn't cost much. As I look toward the school, watching the people coming and going proves a surprisingly entertaining way of passing time as I eat. Little children accompanied by parents or grandparents skipper about the din from the event to event, one hand dragging their company and another bearing an oversized colorful snack. I can't help but notice the age range among the people here is skewed toward the elderly, something that I also noticed when walking around town. This must be one of those towns where the only people left are those who lived here their whole lives and ardently refuse to leave, and those wanting to leave live their days out, and those wanting to live out the rest of their days in one of the increasingly few tranquil places. I guess that also goes a way to explaining how conservative Mako school culture seems to be. Not that I mind one bit, I kind of like how calm Yamaku is and its surroundings are. The heat, though, is not another matter entirely. Sitting in one place for so long has
focused my mind on how annoyingly humid it's getting, and now the hottest part of any day is here. I'd better get moving if I... Gah! The sound of a carry-on bell takes me completely by surprise as I stand up, a reaction shared by a few of the people strolling around as well. The PA system crackles to life after tolling the bell's end. Its age shows as the principal makes a barely intelligible announcement over it, officially opening the festival, and that's very much in full swing. It's quite amusing to contrast the pleasant smiles of the older folk against the alternately pained and bored grimaces of the younger charges. The students, on the other hand, seem to pay little heed. Nevertheless, as the address finally ends, all are united in polite, if not overly enthusiastic, applause, and then get back to business. Slipping a hand in my pocket to look as relaxed as possible, I casually glance around for something to do. It's somewhat difficult to see very far with all the people around. I decide to fall back on a tried and trusted rule, go where everyone else seems to be gathering. Right now, that's the school courtyard and surroundings. Throwing the used plate into the trash can, I make my way toward the school building. Seeing the number of stalls around the perimeter of the school building surprises me. Quite a few of the classes I must have opted to have multiple stalls. In deciding which to visit first, I catch a sight of a familiar banner with a blue patterned border and red text. Lily Stall is as good a place as any to start. I'm curious as to how it's going, after all the work that she and her class have been doing for it. Is that the sign we made? I highly doubt it, because Jesus Christ, that's really intricate. Stepping up to it, I begin to see why the class took so long to organize everything. Easily twice as wide as many of the other stalls, and with equipment for cooking strewn everywhere, it's closer to an outdoor restaurant than a festival event. As a student in front of me takes a bowl of noodles and leaves, I walk up to the counter. The girl behind it seems quite exasperated and asks me to wait a moment before she disappears underneath the counter. Seizing the moment, I take a quick glance around. Steam seems to be rising from everywhere as pots and pans simmer away, and most of the blind students are unpacking ingredients while being helped by someone who is probably the teacher of 3-2. It doesn't take long to notice Lily among them, talking with the teacher as she quickly counts out the boxes and packets with her fingers. From her expression and the fact that both she and the teacher seem to be in a state of mild confusion, it appears that there's some problem in coordination. Before I can stare any longer, the girl behind the counter pops up again, only to look back and ask where the spare change box is. Lily pauses for a moment before she and the girl switch places at the counter, and the teacher quietly walks off somewhere. Sorry about that, we're having a few problems. What would you like? It takes me a second to remember what I'd come here for. My eyes quickly dart to the side, through the menu sitting on the counter. I guess some miso soup. Is that Hisao? Yep, looks like you're pretty busy. Her face all but confirms it as she drops her waitress facade. Jesus Christ, I just stand up for a second. Somewhere along that line, our order got mixed up and we're trying to fix it now, but it only looks like we have half of what we needed. Wouldn't serving smaller portions cover the over problem? It seems like that's what we'll have to do, though I wish we didn't. The fact that a good half of our class is gone doesn't help either. I glance behind her to see how many people are actually operating the stall. I couldn't be over about 8. I take it that's why your teacher left? That's right, she's going to try and round up a few more of our classmates in order to help. Hearing the sound of footsteps behind me, I stealthily glance backwards to see an elderly couple taking a place in line. I guess I should better stop loitering around and chatting. Here's the money for the soup. Soup. Alright, coming right up. Lily turns and calls for a bowl of miso soup as I hand over the money for it. Taking the coins in her palm, I can't help but notice how efficiently she counts them, and with long, pale fingers. Eventually, satisfied that I've handed over correct change, she puts it into a small metal tray. It isn't long before the soup is made and carefully handed to her, after which she turns and subsequently passes it to me. Thanks, I'll come back to drop off the bowl. Thank you, Hisao. Oh, there's one other thing. Have you seen Hanako? Hanako, no, not today. Why? She gives a small sigh of abject disappointment. It's okay, I was just wondering what she was doing for the festival. You'll come back when you're done, then? Sure, I'll keep an eye out for Hanako too. Thank you, Hisao. I walk off from the stall and find a seat, carefully cradling the steaming wooden bowl in both hands. Compared to the dumplings from before, this is quite nice. A little cool compared to what it probably should be, perhaps, but the flavor is enough to cover for that reasonably well. As I drink, I can't help but feel somewhat guilty for not being as involved in the festival as others. It can't really be helped, considering I was dropped into the school only a week ago. It reminded me of a song, but I couldn't remember what the song was, but it still weighs heavily on my mind. That, and the fact that a few students don't really seem to be enjoying the festival as much as the visitors. Eventually, I finish my bowl and leave for the stall to drop it off. Considering that there seems to be no line at all, I take my time walking up.
It seems the teacher's mission paid off. There are now over a dozen students helping, and much of the unpacking has been done. Despite most of them seeming quite relaxed as they work, Lee still appears to be somewhat stressed. Right, I know what I'll do. Even if it's just one person, I'll make the festival more enjoyable for her. As I place the ball on the counter, I call out to Lily. Hisao, you brought it back? Yeah, here. I slide into her hands, and she takes it over to someone who's apparently on cleaning duty. Considering that I didn't see them there before, it's probably a penalty for their tardiness. Hey, Lily? She perks up and returns to the counter as she hears my voice again, realizing that I'm still here. Want to go see some more of the festival? She puffs. Oh my god, she looks so cute. She puffs her cheeks disapprovingly. It looks kind of cute and in complete contradiction to her usual reserved nature. Oh, with your baby. I want to pinch your cheeks. I'll do it with a mouse. Oops. I forgot clicking actually changed the dialogue. My bad. It takes a few seconds for me to get what she's taking issue with. Whoops. I didn't mean to. Lily giggles at me, exposing her teasing for what it is. You're still not used to the school, aren't you? She got me. Still, I kinda need to stay with our stall. It's taking it until now to even get everything unpacked. I guess her reluctance shouldn't overly surprise me, considering how much work she put into this. Everything seems to be running fine now, though. Besides, you've got extra help on hand anyway. A boy in the middle of cooking some soba noodles turns towards us, grinning. Go on, Lil, see if you earned yourself a break. We can hold down the fort for now. If you say it's okay, then I suppose so. But if you need any help, then we'll call you. Go on, we'll be fine. Lily finally gives up her resistance as he waves a spatula at her. She feels her way around the back of the stall and picks up her cane on the way. I guess the first thing we should do is look for Hanako. Lily seems kind of worried about her, and I doubt she'll be the kind of person to enjoy milling about in crowds like this all alone. So I guess we should search for Hanako. Where to first? The both of us go quiet for a moment to think. Maybe she's in her dorm room. I doubt it. She doesn't keep too many things in there, so she'd have nothing to do. The library? As good a place as any to search for an avid reader, I suppose. The library it is. We'll check there first, then. Aside from the muffled sounds of the crowd seeping in from outside, the inside of the school seems almost deserted. In order to make sure everyone had enough room, I guess all the events were organized to be held outside, on school grounds. They're definitely quite large by any other school standards. It's nice and quiet in here, isn't it? Yeah, much nicer than the hustle and bustle outside. We take our time and slowly walk through the first floor of the school, eventually reaching the stairs on the second floor. I can't help but notice by how Lily anticipates every door and obstacle, her cane remaining still and her hands skating along the hallway railings. I'm pretty sure she memorizes the school physically by now. Sorry guys, just adjusting the mic. You really know the school well, don't you? She smiles and nods straight ahead. I've been here for a few years now, so I know where everything is. The dorms still trip me up though, sometimes. I haven't been there as long, and they're not as well laid out as the main building. If I'm remembering right, they used to be unused buildings before being renovated and used as dormitories. That explains why the male and female dorms look different from the outside and why their rooms seem kind of unusual for sleeping quarters. I'd assume she'd been living in the dormitory since she began attending the school, but now I'm reminded of what she said yesterday. That's right, you mentioned that before. I'd assume that most of the students here lived in the dormitories once they enrolled. A lot of them seem to, in any case. Lily's exception becomes somewhat harder to read, my question evidently touching on a delicate point. Well, how should I say? Everyone has their reasons. Something tells me that one of those with reasons is Hanako, has her tiptoeing around the answer. My own predicament is yet another such case. I guess it's a choice everyone here would have to make for themselves, or in my instance, have made for them. It can't be helped, I suppose. At least Yamako itself seems like a nice place. It's good to hear you say that. I thought you were coming to dislike it. What about you, though? My reversal of Lily's statement takes her by surprise. I've been here for a while, so... It's not that. You just seem to be pretty depressed about Akira. What's with that look? Akira's taken. Sorry, Hisao. Oh, she's teasing me some more. Lily never sees how fast my palm meets my face in a sly accusation. Hey, I was worried about you. That's no way to respond to concern. While she gives an amused grin, we round the corner of the hallway and enter the library. That's great. She likes to tease. I love people who don't mind teasing other people.
Oh, we found her! Yay! As we do so, it isn't hard to spot Hanako, considering that the room is completely devoid of anyone else. Given that there are no staff around, I guess there's no need to heed the usual library rules. I call out to her. Hey, Hanako. Hanako is here? As she hears our voices, Hanako's head flicks up from behind a book, probably the same one she's been reading on Friday. Kisao? Lily? Just thought we'd drop by. Lily just managed to escape from the noodle stall with a little help. That wasn't really an escape. Hanako gives a small giggle. Oh, look at her, she's so cute. Briefly surprising both of us. I just thought that Lily might not be enjoying the festival. Well, now we can enjoy it together, right? The two nod happily before we set out of the library toward the festivities. Yay! I can't do it too much, my throat is so sore. Like, despite my throat being sore, I like doing the voices. It's not gonna stop me. Being sick never stops me. Okay, I hand over some change to the girl behind the counter. I take two styrofoam cups of tea. I try to accentuate my bow a bit to cover for the fact that she's quite obviously deaf. Come to think of it, I probably should have asked for help instead of leaving those two in the gardens while I bought drinks. Trying to juggle the two cups of hot tea for them and a can of coffee for myself out of the vending machine, it isn't exactly easy. With some careful maneuvering, though, I manage to keep everything stable and upright as I walk over to the bench where Lily and Hanako are sitting and chatting. It's actually quite a nice place, lit only by moonlight. It's tucked away at some distance from the main events. Compared to how hot it had been during the day, this spot had also so pleasantly cool by now. Not that it matters all that much. Most of the visitors have moved to areas that are either closer to the fireworks or higher on the hill in order to view the display apparently planned. Welcome back, Kisao. Her ears are good. I'm not exactly close, and even Hanako hadn't noticed me. Here you go. Sorry it's instant, but that's all they had left by now. Hanako gingerly takes a cup from my right hand, and I gently place the other into Lily's outstretched hands. Did you enjoy the festival then, Hisao? Yeah, it was pretty fun. An honest answer. Much of the food may have been somewhat subpar, but it was a lot of fun in the end, especially with Hanako and Lily. Yeah, usually festival food's not that great. It's usually deep-fried some stuff, but other stuff is really good, like local food and stuff like that, homemade food. That's something that's great, depending on the festival. But then again, this was made by students, so can't expect too much. In fact, I think those two may have enjoyed themselves even more than I did. With both Lily and me around, much of Hanako's withdrawn nature around others died down enough for her to enjoy herself. Oh god. Okay, what just happened? Like, it just flashed over Hanako's face. Jesus Christ. As we sit drinking, the whistle of the first firework rings up before it explodes into a vibrant shower of blue against the night sky, heralding the beginning of the end for the festival. Hang on, someone sent me a Snapchat, I just want to look at it. Enthusiastic shouts can be heard from the crowd scattered around the school grounds celebrating them. For minutes on end, Hanako and I watch the fireworks overhead as Lily blissfully listens to them with her eyes shut. Red, green, yellow, star-shaped, circular, and pattern, and all manners of shapes and colors fill the air. And at one after the other, and dances across the sky. No place near where I live put on such a lavish displays. Festivals like this were a thing of the past in such metropolitan areas. To be seeing such a sight with these two, it's probably the happiest I've been in a long while. Aw, the music, it gave me chills. Like, it's soothing, it's very soothing. I kind of just want to sit back and enjoy this, because, like, it's a really, really moving moment. Like, I never ever done something like this, sit in a nice open area and just watch fireworks and let the silence seep in. It's quite relaxing, honestly. Well, enough of that. I gave myself a moment, that's all I'm giving myself. So, that's it. The festival's finally ending. Yeah. She gives a delicate, wistful sigh. As much as I might complain about all the stuff we have to do, it's still sad that we'll have to graduate it before the next Yamaku Festival. I know that feeling, actually, because, my first year of college, kind of got ambitious. For one of the clubs I'm in, they put on a sort of play every year, and, I jumped in to help, and, I didn't know what I was going to do, so, like, in trying to help out everyone, I took the job of lights, because no one apparently likes doing lights. So I took it, and, all the late nights, all of the, like, we'd literally stay up till 3 in the morning sometimes, like, rehearsing and doing all that stuff. And I had 8 a.m. classes, so, like, it wasn't, like, the greatest time. But on the day of the play, everyone was like super happy, super energetic. We got to sleep in a little bit. And it was just wonderful, a wonderful thing. And going through everything, like, it was a little rushed. Sometimes I messed up on the light work, like, and everyone was had each other's backs. It was something amazing. And at the end of the day, when all that stress disappeared, it was weird because, like, I met some of the closest friends I had that day, for the first time. And over the course of rehearsing for plays and planning out scripts and just going on late night trips with people to, like, food places just because we wanted to celebrate a good rehearsal, I can honestly say that despite the stress, it was worth it in the end because I met some really, really true friends. And I guess this festival in the game is reminds me of that, and it makes me feel really happy. It honestly makes me feel really, really happy. Oh god, my heart's just really, really soft. But yeah, that's what it reminded me of, and I guess that's why I feel so happy right now. I don't know. It almost brings tears to my eyes, in all honesty. And I shouldn't be covering my mouth, but my hands are by my mouth, and I'm just reminiscing. That's what the music feels like. It feels reminiscent of something, but I guess that's what it is. And no, the sniffling is not from me crying. It's because I have a cold. As I walk forwards, I stand beside Lily, gently resting a hand on her shoulder. Don't worry. We'll still have Tanabata later in the year, right? You're right. It would be nice to go there when it comes. Minutes of silence pass with only the blast of the fireworks to be heard. Seeing these two reminds me of those words of advice Lily had given me as we walked into town together. Cherish the opportunity to make a new friend, huh? Yeah. Yeah. That's something real. That's something real right there. Because you never know when in life you're going to meet friends you're going to have forever. Friends that that when you actually make time to see, like, it's actual quality time. Like, it's something. It's something undescribable. Like, you know the feeling when it's there. And I know I'm getting so sappy right now, but that's how I feel. And if any of my friends ever watch this, and I know they will. I know some of them will. I love you guys, and I can't imagine my life without you. So, there's that. Enough of me being sappy. Jesus Christ. Hey, Lily? She turns her head slightly to show that she's listening, Hanako's gaze still firmly fixed on the technicolor fireworks bursting overhead. Mind if I join you two for tea every now and again? The smile on her face is more than enough to see her answer. It would be a pleasure, Hisao.
Lily path.
Oh, that's her animated? Okay. Okay, clearly it has something to do with her sister. I don't know what it is, and, yeah, like, her emotional trouble definitely has something to do with her sister. But, I'm gonna have to end this part here. Perfect ending, right? We got to see, Lily CG, and, I have to admit, I'm glad we saw that, because, like, I don't know what happened at the end there, but it just made me feel really happy. I don't know what it is about this game, but it just makes me so happy at times. Like, sometimes it's long-winded, sometimes it's annoying, but during legitimate emotional parts, I get really happy. I get really, really happy. I don't know what it is. Like, the game is so soft and tranquil. It's not like an RPG where, like, you get a really legitimate emotional moment, the next thing you know, you're back to normal gameplay. This entire thing is a journey. It's a journey, and I have to say that about this game. Like, It's great. It's a beautiful, beautiful game, and I have to say I love it. Like, god. Like, there are parts of this game that get me legitimately wound up, legitimately emotional, and legitimately, like, it breaks me down to my core and makes me go, wow, it's so great to be alive. Like, I don't know. This game is amazing. This game is amazing. It's written very, very amazingly, and it's like I'm at the end of the game right now, but no, like, I have to say these words, but yeah, it's awesome. So anyway, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video, hit that like button. If you want to see more videos from me, hit the subscribe button. And I'm burping. And you are now exiting the Shadyverse. My name's Shades, and I hope you've enjoyed your day in the shade. See you guys later.